You won't find a traditional hot water heater in the Leonard's home. That's because Steve Leonard has gone tankless.
It's nice to always have hot water and not have to worry about that.
I'm in Steve Leonard's garage, and can you find his hot water heater? It's not over here. It's not over here. But I am getting warmer. I'm getting warmer. In fact, I'm starting to burn up. His hot water heater used to be a big tank sitting right here. But now his hot water heater is just that little silver box right up there on the wall.
My daughter comes back from college with her her friends, and they use the pool, they use the showers, they go out for the evening. It used to be where I would have to wait an hour before I could take a shower, and now there's always hot water.
Now here's what we're talking about. This is the set system. And let me give you a little tour inside. Right over there, that microprocessor, that's the brains of the operation. And in each one of these cylinders right here is a heating element, and that's what heats the hot water. Now, obviously, as opposed to a traditional tank hot water heater, this is a whole lot smaller. But not only does it save in space, it also saves in energy, I'm told between 30% and 40%. That's because, as opposed to a traditional tank hot water heater, which is constantly on heating those gallons of water and keeping them at a certain temperature, this is off when the water's not on. You can see we've attached a little amp meter in this demonstration right here, and it's off when there's no water running through it. When you turn on some water, which I'm going to do right now, there you can see there's some energy running through it. If I turn on an additional, let's say, a shower as well, it's using up even more energy. But when I turn off the shower and I turn off the faucet here, the energy cuts off. So that's how it saves energy, by when there's no water running through the system, there's no energy being used. Now, one difference between the set system and a traditional hot water heater is that with a traditional hot water heater, it's usually set at, let's say, 140 degrees, and because the temperature coming out of the tank isn't always consistent, you add some cold water when you're taking your shower. With the set system, it's so consistent that you basically set it at a temperature, usually the temperature of the person who likes the hottest shower in your home. When they take their shower, they just use hot water, and the other family members add a little bit of cold so that they're at a temperature they're comfortable with. Now, another way the set system doesn't mirror a traditional hot water heater is here in the bathroom. With a typical tank, you get 40 to 60 gallons of hot water. Once you've used it up, you're looking at some cold showers until it refills and reheats. With the set system, you could literally turn your shower on and run it 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, and you'd be getting hot water. The only drawback is you can only run maybe one or two showers at a time. If you're looking at two, three, or four showers, that's more than the system can handle. Joining me is Carlos Cabrera, president of Set Systems. And Carlos, you were telling me earlier that some folks keep their tank hot water heater and add the Set Systems to it. What's the advantage of that?
Well, Steve, as hot water is flown out of the tank, cold water is flown into the tank, which reduces your available temperature or amount of hot water. By using our system as a booster, the cold water coming in from the street goes through our unit, back out of the unit and into the tank at a much higher temperature, and therefore it gives you a much greater available amount of hot water.
So this way, a home that wants to do two or three or four showers at the same time, they can do it with a booster.
That is correct.
Now, as far as installing it goes, how does installing the set systems compare to installing a traditional hot water heater?
Very similar. You have your cold water coming in, hot water coming out. There's no need for a pressure relief valve, as is the case with a storage tank, because there's no water storage.
So it's actually a little bit easier then?
A little bit easier.
Cost-wise, how does the set systems compare to a traditional hot water when we're looking at cost?
Pretty much the same price as a storage tank, around $300.
The Set Systems heat exchanger is made of brass and copper and is welded with silver. It's guaranteed for life. And because there's no standing water in a tank, there's no calcium buildup, which can ruin traditional hot water heaters. Set Systems has a smaller unit for single point-of-use faucets, and they're also working on a prototype for a pool heater. Right now, most of these tankless water heaters are being sold through builders and power companies that like the fact that this product is so energy efficient. But Steve Leonard's favorite feature is...
It's good to have the extra space, there's no doubt about that. It's good to be able to pull both cars in the garage. It's good to be able to have extra space for the washer, dryer, etc.
So if you think you're in hot water because of a lack of space, you're not necessarily all washed up. For your new house, I'm Steve Greenberg.